herbs in Berlin, it can be kind of daunting because you're like, here you are in the city and you're in an apartment, and what can I pick and what can't I pick, and is it legal, is it not legal, where can I go? Okay, here's the thing. In German tradition, there is this idea that you have the right to a Handstrauch, and that word means hand bouquet. That's as much as you can carry in one hand. And this is, you know, based on this whole Central and Eastern European thing where they think of fresh flowers as being a necessity, right? It's like food and water and fresh flowers. So that's part of what the parks are for, you know? They're for playing sports and they're for relaxing and, you know, they're for hanging out in, but they're also so that we have a place where we can, you may have parks near you that have cherries or apples or whatever, but also, I mean, the elderflowers and the lilacs, those are also, it's okay to harvest one handful. An exception, if you see a sign that says Naturschutz and it has an owl, that means that that place is reserved for biodiversity. That is not a place where you can gather herbs or forage for any kind of edibles. You have to leave that alone for nature. So then another question about harvesting in the city is safety in terms of, I mean, is this thing safe to eat, right? One of the biggest concerns when it comes to harvesting in the city in Berlin is there's a fox tapeworm, which we don't want to catch that. So basically any place where dogs or foxes could have been using the bathroom, I don't harvest from there. So that means, I mean, basically I don't harvest very much that grows on the ground. I focus on things that are at a nice height where, you know, dogs didn't get on it. At the same time, personally, I mean, the flowers are for everyone. I think it's a really important part of the social and aesthetic life of the city that we have these flowers for everybody in the park. And so I always try to think, how is this gonna look without this flower? So like today I harvested this lilac. And I made sure to do it was in a place where it was like, it was pretty low to the ground and it was underneath another bush. You couldn't really see it anyway. So somebody walking by isn't gonna have any less of a lilac experience because this one thing isn't here. And let me show you, I mean, today I felt like I got a really good haul and it's this much, right? I mean, if you have a garden or you've lived out in the country, you're looking at that like, seriously? But you know, I mean, here we are in the city, and this is, you know, this is a few days worth of tea, so, you know, you don't need that much, you don't need that much. Today I got linden, and I got lilacs, and then yesterday I got roses, and I just got three blossoms, and a little bit of leaf, but, you know, that's enough for some tea. Okay, so I talked about the, you know, watch out for where foxes or dogs could have been. And flowers are for everyone. Don't pick the ones in a pretty spot. What else? Oh, also caring for the plants. So, all right, when I'm gonna harvest from a plant, perennial plants, right? So like things that come back every year, but they lose their leaves and then they regrow leaves. What ends up happening is, you know, the plant is growing its leaves so that it can receive sunshine and, you know, use that to make energy. So it starts leafing out in places that are going to get covered later by the other leaves, right? So when you look at the structure of the plant as you're harvesting, you know, think in terms of like, how do I remove leaves in such a way that it's not having to put energy, the plant no longer has to put this energy into leaves that aren't receiving any light, and some other leaves are going to receive more light. That makes sense. Try to increase the efficiency of the light hitting the leaves, and you'll be helping the plant. Yes. And what else? I guess that's about it. I want to emphasize, like, that. I don't know, I think it's easy to get this idea with harvesting and foraging that you want to get these huge quantities. And one of the things I really like about the whole Handstrauch thing is that it's like, you could have this much, you know, and that's enough. It's like, I got a little bit of roses, I got a little bit of lilac. And what I've found is that if you go for a walk every day and you get one handful every day, it ends up being a lot. It ends up being a lot of herb. And, one thing I left out. I wanted to mention picking up windfall. So this is something that I do a lot. I have harvested a lot of plants this way. I've gotten, poplar and cottonwood drop branches a lot. I should back up and say, okay, windfall, what I mean is right after there's been a windstorm, if you notice, like, oh, it's really windy, and then it gets still, if you go out, and pick up what's fallen, a lot of plants are going to drop just these little end pieces that are, you know, the really nice kind of the part you would want anyway, right? And I've done that with cottonwood and poplar do that really easily. They drop a lot of little ends, and so do walnut and pecan, but I've also gathered linden that way, and hazel I've gathered that way also. It's just something to think about if you notice a gust of wind, and then it might be a good time where you can go out and get your Handstrauch from the park without even having to, you know, pull, cut, anything. It might just be laying there on the ground waiting for you. All right. I hope you are having a great day and that you will enjoy going out and getting something fresh from the outdoors. Peace out.